The Philippine government seeks to ensure the safety of Filipino seafarers held hostage at a hijacked ship in the Red Sea. Manila's Foreign Office confirmed Wednesday that 17 seafarers were among the 25 persons on board the Galaxy Leader ship held hostage by Iran-backed Houthi rebels. The agency says diplomatic representations with governments are underway to rescue the seafarers. Ahmed Yemeni rebels seized a cargo ship said to be partially owned by an Israeli businessman on November 19. That ship, operated by a Japanese company, doesn't have any Israeli crew member. The Houthis, a known ally of Tehran, have been launching long-range missiles at Israel in solidarity with Hamas.
Analysts welcome the life-saving pause for residents of the Gaza Strip. A lecturer from the Australian National University believes both sides are serious about the deal and the truce will likely hold for at least the first 4 days. But he also warns the window for peace will not be enough time to help those affected in Gaza.
It's absolutely not enough. The Gaza Strip is home to more than 2.3 million Palestinians. These have been cut off from all sorts of necessary items, from fuel to water to obviously electricity, humanitarian equipment and material, as well as food items. So it's not enough. However, it is better than the current situation, and it will provide a much needed relief.
Around 307 individuals have been affected by heavy rains brought by the shear line and the Visayas. The National Disaster Agency says they're staying in some 104 evacuation centers across five regions. In the municipality of Palapag, Northern Samar, 32 villages experienced either landslides or flooding. No casualties or missing persons have been reported as authorities focus on evacuating affected households and extending aid where necessary.
We are now coordinating with our good governor, Governor Edwin Ongjuan, for the possible sa mga relief goods para sa mga evacuees. At the same time, kagabi kausap ko ang regional director ng DSWD, si Arlie Gray Subong, para po sa possible po ng pag-transport ng mga goods, so food packs, especially doon sa mga affected na families.
The mayor of Glan in Sarangani vows support for those affected by the powerful tremors that hit the municipality. Now, the quake in southern Mindanao last week was followed by a magnitude 4.9 tremor in Sarangani Tuesday. At least five people have died there, while 85 others were injured. Glan is now under a state of calamity.
We are very busy giving relief goods to the affected families, and nagbibigay po din yung DSWD ng assistance for those partially and totally damaged houses. Because in all, partially and totally damaged houses nasa 2,300.
Two Philippine Air Force aircraft take part in the country's joint patrol with U.S. forces. The FA-50PH planes flew over the vicinity of Batanes Province and other areas of the West Philippine Sea as part of the joint activity that will run until November 23. In a message to reporters, AFP spokesperson Colonel Medel Aguilar says the joint patrols are not meant to escalate tensions in the West Philippine Sea. He says the drills are meant to display Manila's firm resolve in asserting its sovereign rights and jurisdiction. The drills also aspire to uphold conventions that promote the peaceful resolution of maritime conflicts. The National Security Council calling on a group to abandon its planned civilian mission to Ayungin Shoal. The Atinito Coalition earlier announced its plans to bring supplies to troops stationed at the BRP Sierra Madre. But for NSC Assistant Director General Jonathan Malaya, the convoy could place the Philippines in a difficult position. He expressed worry for the safety of participating civilians, given the recent dangerous maneuvers of Chinese militia vessels towards Philippine resupply ships.
The civilian convoy places the Philippines in a very difficult position, precisely because China, I would presume, would never believe that this is not a government sanctioned operation or mission. And given the heightened tensions between the Philippines and China over the Ayungin Shoal, it would be best, no, if the coalition behind this planned Christmas convoy, Atin Ito, would just bring Christmas cheer or holiday cheer to Philippine troops in Pag-asa, in Lawak, in Parola, no? And, you know, there are also civilian communities and Philippine troops in this area, and they also deserve a Christmas cheer. Mm. No, why not focus their attention to these features?